that syllabus should be cut these days, because there's a lot of burden on the children anyways. Like, and also like the extracurricular activities like dancing, and we also have many inter-school activities. So it's like a lot of burden for us anyways.
Actually, it's too much of burden for the students to study so much of, and in 1 year or a certain period of time. So it is too much of stress for the students.
The government has heard you. Soon, the NCERT syllabus is to be reduced by half. And the HRD ministry is inviting suggestions from the public for revamping the entire curriculum.
Prakash Javadekar also said that this syllabus that the students are studying in the from the NCERT textbooks is very huge and large in number, such that, you know, they do not get time for any kind of extra co-curricular activity. And the logic that the government is giving behind the cutting of syllabus is where they are looking at suggestions from all stakeholders like parents, teachers, educationists, NGOs and the students themselves, of what they would like that should be edited or what they want that should be changed from this particular syllabus. And right now we are looking at a big task ahead of the NCERT people. They'll have to chalk out a new plan of what really needs to be kept in a particular curriculum, because we're looking at an overhaul that the government wants to do of the syllabus from class 1 till class 12.
Parents are cautious about how the move will pan out. Many fear that reducing the portion from classes 1 to 10 may make their children lose out in competitive exams.
10th mein jaise abhi graduation mein semester pattern hua hai, us pattern se semester pattern hona chahiye 10th mein, aur 12th mein bhi waise hi pattern hona chahiye, aur kam bhi wo semester pattern rahega to apna study mein bhi ye ho jayega. कम ज्यादा यानी प्रेशर भी ज्यादा नहीं रहेगा लड़कों लोगों को.
हाँ, सिलेबस तो कम होना चाहिए क्योंकि उसके वजह से बच्चों पर बहुत प्रेशर पड़ रहा है, और अगर सिलेबस कम होगा तो उनको कम टाइम ज्यादा मिलेगा पढ़ने के लिए, और उसके वजह से उनको ज्यादा बेनिफिट हो सकता है एग्जाम.
सिलेबस कम होने से पढ़ाई मतलब जो एजुकेशन मतलब जो स्टडी रहेगी वो भी कम होगी, तो कोई इश्यू नहीं रहेगा, और सिलेबस कम होने से ज्यादा मतलब डिप्रेशन नहीं आएगा, और सभी बच्चों को जो भी क्वेश्चन है आंसर है वो भी कम हो जाएंगे, तो लर्न करने के लिए याद करने के लिए बहुत अच्छा रहेगा.
As the government seeks suggestions to reduce the load on students, Mirror Now asks, are our students overburdened? Will reducing the syllabus by half reduce student stress? Or do we need more holistic intervention? Let's debate.
We're watching the Urban Debates on Mirror Now, and we had an interesting question to answer today when we were going to decide what we want to do on this particular primetime show. Now, there are lots of things going on in our country. First of all, we have the statue wars, or the statue politics, or the statue nonsense, whatever the hashtag may be today, that has actually gotten a lot worse, and it's gotten a lot more disturbing. We also have politics that's playing out across the country, where we know that two members of parliament have broken away from the government. Now, while that does take up a lot of prime time space, we have to also consider what's important to you. And as a result, and as we constantly keep saying that we will focus on policy and not politics, we will not waste your time with politics, we've figured out that there is a much bigger story that requires much more of your attention. And that story is simply this. Across the country, the NCERT, which is the governing board that decides the syllabus for CBSE, and a lot of the state governments and the state syllabus gets picked up from the NCERT as well. The NCERT, under the government of India, under the Human Resource Ministry, has decided that it might actually slash the curriculum that our students are having to study by half, thereby giving them more time so they can play more, they can do more sports, they can carry lighter bags to school, and perhaps have a more rounded personality. Now, the reason why this is really important is because between now and the 6th of April, you have, as citizens of the country, the opportunity to go onto the NCERT website and give your suggestions on whether you think this is a good idea or a bad idea, or if there's a specific textbook that you believe should be changed in a certain way. Now, why is this important? Because there is a limited amount of time in which you can give your suggestions, after which the decision will be taken. once the decision is taken, it will affect how we raise our children. Remember, you and I are an entire generation of people who were raised on a certain format of education. We will be changing that format of education for the children in the future. And we have to, at this point, spend some time trying to decide if this is a good thing or a bad thing. Now, there are two schools of thoughts. Parents who believe that children are being overburdened with too much homework, too much studying, and they should be given a rest. And the others who believe that we're being soft on our children right now, because this is exactly the kind of system that you and I were raised in. And if we don't teach our children this way, they won't be competitive. They won't be able to achieve everything that's being achieved across the world by Indians right now. So also, I have a poll that's open on my Twitter feed. Please go in and vote. I'll tell you the results at the end of the poll. Our phone lines are open. We've got extra phone lines on this particular show because we want you to weigh in on the entire subject. But joining me on the show, Anubha Sahai is the president of India Worldwide Parents Association. Kavita Sanghvi, secretary of the members of international schools. Firoz Bakht Ahmed is an educationalist. R.S. Rajput, former director of the NCERT. And we have Dr. Professor Vikram Singh, pro-chancellor of the Noida International University, also former DGP Police Uttar Pradesh. We have Arjun Deveya as a student counselor and a mentor right now. And I understand from my producers that the panel is split evenly for and against this particular move to reduce the syllabus. So we're going to do opening statements right now. And I'm going to start with Kavita Sanghvi, who's a principal and an educationist. Kavita, you believe that it's a bad idea to hack the curriculum by half. Why so?
No, I don't have a problem with completely cutting the curriculum, but cutting it by half, that means I just want, 1 second, can you hear me? Am I heard?
Yes, we can hear you, we can hear you. Yes, 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 you are. Please
Hello?
Go ahead.
Yeah, okay. So my question is basically very pertinent question is, the initiative is good that you want to reduce the burden on the students, but first of all, where is the research to understand what is to be retained and what is to be discarded? So how are you going to gather evidence? What you're asking for are suggestions. So this is basically, are you planning to go in for some randomized trial, something to understand that your suggestions are validated? Also, if you're changing the pattern, so if you're changing the pattern, is the assessment pattern also changing to address the curriculum? Are the teachers going to be involved in the curriculum planning? And how are you planning to train teachers on skills? Because you plan to change a curriculum to an entire for building skills. So how are you planning to train the teachers?
In fact, how you plan? I have to also bring in Anubha Sahai from the Parents Association, who believes this is a good idea. Anubha Sahai, why do you believe that?
Yeah, I do appreciate and I support what Kavita ma'am has said just now, because we need to take opinion of all the stakeholders, be it parents or be it teachers or school management and educationists also, before taking any decision. And I think that's why the government has come up, HRD ministry has come up with this suggestion thing, which they are inviting suggestions from all the stakeholders. They're inviting suggestions from all the parents and even teachers and management. So I appreciate this initiative taken up by HRD ministry, because a lot of parents were complaining. Some parents were in support of this move, but there were many parents who were complaining. They said some had concern whether this will again reduce the, if the syllabus will get reduced, then don't know if the children will be able to compete in the competitive exams. Because even I am from a KV school, I have studied in KV school, in CBSE board, and during our time, all the exams which were conducted at central level, central exams, CET or any other test which used to get conducted, CPMT was there. So all the central level examinations, were the syllabus which was being followed was by NCERT. NCERT syllabus used to be followed during in such exams. Now, if government is going to change the curriculum of NCERT, whether they are going to change the examination pattern also, because then how will the children will know, get to know that what all are, is, will be there in the examination, that is central PET or central level MBA exams or central level management exams or maybe CPMT which used to have. So what the ma'am has said from the school side, I totally support her. The government should take consent of all the stakeholders, from parents, from student side also. They should also take the consent of students, what they feel, what kind of curriculum they want. Recently,
do you actually mean that we should ask students what they want to learn? I mean, students will turn around and say that they don't want to learn maths, so they don't want to learn a particular subject that they think is boring. What point do we consult students on what they do and do not want to learn?
Yeah, I'll get you on that. Recently, one student from Singapore tweeted me. He said that this is a very good decision on part of the which the government is taking, but they should ensure, because CBSE curriculum is being followed across, in other countries also, not only in India. In Singapore, what he told me that they focus more on practical based subjects, and the CBSE curriculum which is followed in India is not that good as compared to other CBSE boards in other countries. So that is what that student told me. So the students are aware that what is happening in other countries also, because they are studying.
Right. So let me bring in Vikram Singh. Vikram Singh, Vice Chancellor of Noida International University. Mr. Singh, are we mollycoddling our children here by saying that let's ask the children what they want to study, let's take their feedback, let's make sure that they don't have to study so many hours a day? Mr. Singh?
Faye, I would say that it is not child's play. Constant improvement, upgradation, rationalization of the syllabus is an imperative. But let the experts do it. I know our children are overburdened. They need a break. But at the same time, they have to compete with the very best in the world. In the process of giving them some respite, I only hope they do not lose out hopelessly in the race to perfection. I have students from 26 countries in my university. And I wish I could tell you that unless you are the very best, I got 70% when I was in 10, it doesn't take me very far. I was at the topper at that time. 70% today does not take you anywhere. Similarly, 20 years ago, Cray XMP supercomputers, your simple smartphone has more computing power on it than the Cray XMP mainframe IBM computers. These are interesting times. Robotics, artificial intelligence, right, cloud, big cloud data, these have to be incorporated amongst our students. As the lady had said, Singapore students on an average study 12 hours a day, and that is why Singapore is Singapore. Of course, I would like my children to be relaxed. I would like my children not to harm themselves, but I would also like my children to be the best in the world, which they have a destiny for and to pursue. Therefore, in any country, advanced country, as in Germany or elsewhere, the system is get 200 experts, put them on an island, let them be in isolation, live like hermits for about 3 months, and come out with a solid proposal. Let it be evaluated, examined, and then be constantly upgraded over a period of time. It is an expert's job. It is a specialist job. It cannot be a knee-jerk reaction. Incorporating the best of worldly practices and the latest in technology, science, literature, special and liberal arts calls for a lot of application and forethought. Therefore, my recommendation would be to have the best people incorporate the best practices and come out with a cogent, logical, and a practical.
No, but do you believe, Vikram Singh, that the NCRTC is not the best option right now, or they are not the experts for whatever reason?
I would say that I have had the occasion to see the publications now. I would reserve my comments because there are very respectable people on the panel. I would ask them also, but I was very disappointed in seeing the science publications for what. I was very disappointed.
Well, I want to bring in Mr. J.S. Rajput to respond to that, former director of the NCERT who joins us on the panel. Mr. Rajput, what is your response to what Mr. Vikram Singh is saying, that some of the publications coming out of the NCERT are actually right now a little disappointing in the quality, and that's what we should be fixing before we do anything else?
No, that is not the main point of debate. The main point is very different. What has been told to me by your people, the issue is curriculum load reduction is not a new issue. It has been there for over 3 decades, and Sri R.K. Narayan has initiated it on the nationwide scale when he spoke at the Rajya Sabha in 1989. Then came an Ashpal committee report and pointed out, it was assisted by experts, consisted of experts, what is the meaning of curriculum load. It is not only physical load. It's a load of comprehension. It's a load of understanding things. And another thing that you must have discussed today in detail is Gurudev Rabindranath Tagore said the best blessing that a child has are power of ideas and power of imagination. Now to these two I add curiosity and creativity. Now these are the four terms around which you develop the curriculum. These are the binding lines. If you are crushing these particular benefits, particular blessings that the child has, then your curriculum must be revised. And this we feel as experts, as people who have worked in the field for 3 to 4 decades, that yes, revision is necessary. Minister is very right. They should be reduced. I'm not very much worried about 50% or 41% or 53%. That is not important. The important thing is those four terms. You have to do this. But mere reduction of the textbook is not intended. You can reduce the load only if you go into other factors also. You cannot reduce the load if there is teacher-taught ratio is poor. You cannot reduce the load if the teachers are not fully competent and qualified, if they are not ready. You cannot reduce the load if the new terminology that is being used by every progressive country in education, learning to learn. Now, another thing that has to be noted is teacher is not the only source of information for the child anymore. He is there, he is supposed to assist, he is supposed to help. I heard this discussion and I would like to point out to you that Sri Aurobindo had said something very important. He said, the child must be consulted, the mind must be consulted in its own development. What he meant was, the child has to be consulted, the child can speak. He can tell you what he would like to learn, what children of that stage would like to learn, and researchers do exist. It is not for the first time that issue has been studied. They will be handy to the NCERT. Further, by consulting the whole nation, NCERT will get very rich inputs. I can say with personal experience that I used to get wonderful inputs from children, from the schools. All those things are there, and therefore the issue has to be examined in all its components, in all its variables. It's not only textbook, and it is not by weight or by mathematical question.
Let me also bring in Firoz Bakht Ahmed.
Like that is to be done.
Let me also bring in Firoz Bakht Ahmed, who's an educationalist. And I just want to read, Firoz, before you start speaking, I just want to read a couple of the comments that are coming in on Inball. One person says, will reducing the syllabus create a problem when it comes to jobs? Our current system is such that students' potential is determined by marks, not by interest. The biggest problem is that every parent wants his or her child to excel. But I want to ask you this, Firoz, in terms of the students and we deciding what is best for the students right now, there are obviously two choices. Should we lessen the load of the students in order to allow them to live better, well-rounded lives? Or will this make them less competitive?
Mrs. D'Souza, first of all, let me, before I answer your question, let me congratulate your channel, Mirror Now, that the rider, which you said that instead of politics, we should talk about education, which is the most important thing. So first of all, let me congratulate all your team, first thing. Second thing is that since you are a very sensible anchor in this hullabaloo media world, please give me some time to answer this question. It will take some time. See, I have been associated with the school sector for the last 25 years, first thing. Second thing, also I am associated with the classroom situation. Now this, as rightly pointed out by Mr. Vikram Singh, unfortunately what happens is that from the CBSE or from the HRD ministry or from whatever agencies which are now running the education system in our country, knee-jerk reactions are there. There is an email, there's a circular, yes, we have changed this, we are coming up with this. It has been, in fact, ruining the entire system, though Indian education system is still one of the best in the world. Let me begin from this CC. When Mr. Kapil Sibal was the HRD minister, he actually is a Harvardian. He thought that I should employ all the techniques of Harvard here in India. India is India, West is West. Anyway, with goodwill if he wanted to do it, but it has hardly served any purpose. Parents were burdened with a lot of projects, whatever. Now coming to your present situation, yes, you said it will lessen the weight of the bags, whatever it is. But let me tell you one thing. It can be divided into two things. From classes 1 to 10, yes, there's a lot of weight, right? A lot of burden. So there can be some kind of a system where this course could be lessened. As one of the principals also said in the beginning, yes, there is depression, there is anxiety, there were suicides also. I mean, that can be checked in. So as far as classes 11 and 12 are concerned, there is no need to halve it or dilute it, because as once again, let me point out what Mr. Singh said, we have to be the best in the field of education and we have to be perfect. And if we are diluting, making it half, I don't think, because knowledge level will also be halved, and some people are saying no, extracurricular activities will be there, there will be more time with the children and the parents are burdened. Arey bhai, why should you say that you are burdened if you are helping your children in the field of education? This will be there for the whole of their lives. So what I feel, I should give, you know, I should suggest this Ministry of Education, please don't do it all of a sudden. Involve people who are experts, very rightly pointed out by Mr. Singh, and whatever decision you have to take, you take it. But there has to be involvement of people who are directly associated with the school sector, with the education classroom situation. Otherwise, whatever you are doing might actually not serve the purpose.
Right. Okay. All right. Let me, I just have one more voice to bring in. Arjun Deve as a student counselor. Arjun, go ahead. Are you for or against this?
My pranams to everybody. It is a great debate. I congratulate all the people, those who are on the panel. They brought in a lovely point. Before I can begin, I convey my best wishes to all the women under this sun. A very happy Women's Day. And as a sports person, as an international sports person, people must be wondering that what about education I would be conveying. I would like to mention one thing, ma'am, that the education is supposed to build the students ready for the industry. Otherwise, NASSCOM will keep on saying that. Right now, it says that 70% of the engineers are unfit to the industry. But our academy, Abhimanyu Academy, says 85% of the graduates are unfit to the industry. Mm-hmm. And I would like to mention from here, basically, because now more of a sports is, I mean, less of sports and more of education I have been involved into. To the panelists, what they have spoken, I would like to support their views. Number one is, this is a great initiative by Government of India and particularly the HRD Ministry. This is in the right move, and it is in the interest of the students. Everybody talks about IQ. I want to just convey to everybody who are watching, the viewers all over India. No. IQ is the last one. Believe me honestly, when there are three Qs which combine together, then the IQ comes out. The PQ plus EQ plus the CQ. PQ is the physical quotient, EQ is the emotional quotient, and CQ is the creative quotient. When these three quotients are intact, then the IQ, intelligent quotient, falls at the feet. This is one. And second thing is, when there is a syllabus reduced, I mean the burden of the syllabus is reduced, what they mean, I presume, is that there will be quality education. Instead of giving a lot of knowledge, there will be concepts and theories which will be conveyed to the student in such a way that the concepts will be, the basic foundation will be made strong. And I would Theories and concepts alone do not change the life of the people.
No.
Theories and concepts alone do not change the life of the people, but practicing those theories and concepts will definitely change the life of the people. So the children need more of a practical.
All right. Everybody's made their opening statements. I'm going to open this up now to rebuttals. Three people who believe on the panel that the portions of the students in school should be reduced, and three people who disagree. Arjun, go ahead very quickly.
Ma'am, if I can make one more point, why physical fitness is very important is, not as a sports person I'm trying to tell, not as an international athlete or a national champion, but believe me, the doctor, there is no doctor on the panel, otherwise I'm very sure the doctor would have agreed, or the doctors, those who are watching, will definitely agree, what physical fitness does the academics. Physical fitness builds a hormone called beta endorphin. Beta endorphin is a sign of wellness, and when the child, that wellness is what keeps the child very happy. And then one of the formulas which I always devise is,
so happy children will do better in school.
Happy child, better performance. Yes, happy child, better performance. Better performance, happy family, and when there is a happy family,
there is a
happy
country. I'm opening this up for rebuttals. Vikram Singh first. Vikram Singh believes that this is not a good idea. Vikram Singh, go ahead.
We have three quick points to make. number one, that yes, we also need to invest, since Dr. Rajput had said that the entire ecosystem needs to be reformed. Indeed, it needs to be, because our children seeing 3 to 4 hours of television every day, spending more time on television and the screen, twice as much as they do in the classroom and in the playground, seeing 800 murders per year. Let us do something about that as well. Let us see the crime, hedonism and violence going into their scheme of things. Dr. Rajput has brought out philosophical points. Sa vidya ya vimuktaye, nasti vidya samam chakshuhu. Yes, the best education can be the divine eyes that you can possibly be given. As Swami Vivekananda had also said, education is the manifestation of the perfection already in man. But that perfection and that environment has to be given by a vibrant classroom. Classroom who are not just teachers, they are gurus. It is that students are not just students, they are shishyas. The guru-shishya parampara, the student-teacher relationship, the entire ecosystem when it changes, yes, that is a blessing. But as of now, I find you teachers...
So you believe, so Vikram Singh... Yes. Vikram Singh believes that this is a band-aid solution. You're not actually
precisely
getting into the, under the skin of the problem.
Precisely.
Right. Yeah. Anubha Sahai, your rebuttal, please.
Faye, I would like to comment here actually to all the panelists, all the respected panelists, that see, the recent circular which has come, I'm not talking about the earlier one, about the NCERT syllabus. If you will read the recent circular which has come up from the HRD ministry, they are not talking about doing it like 50%, they are not going to reduce it. No, if you will read the new circular, what they are saying, they are inviting suggestions to bring change in the recent curriculum. What change we need? Because we need updation after every, say, 10 years. This NCERT syllabus has not been updated since many years. So now it is the time that, since the time is changing, I was in school 25 years back, but there was an updation in CBSE curriculum some 10, 15 years back. Now again we need some updation in the NCERT syllabus, because time keeps changing and as per time we should update our syllabus maybe every 5 years or every 10 years. So now it is that it is more than 10 to 15 years. So we should now update this syllabus as and they are inviting suggestions also. So all stakeholders should give suggestions and government should invite all the committee members and educationists to put up their suggestions also, to form a committee. And they can always go and take a call what all should be included in the new syllabus, what all new things we need to change in the syllabus. And at the same time, let all the parents also or another members should also put up their suggestions on the website, which the government has demanded.
All right, so
I really appreciate this initiative. So that it will have a good impact. It will not have a bad impact.
But
it seems a little
haphazard, because I was going through the website and I'm going to take this to Feroz Bakhtemir. Then I'm going to ask my panelists to keep the answers short so that I can take as many callers as possible. We have a young man on the phone line already. Feroz, my question is this. So I went to the website of the NCERT and it has uploaded soft copies of all the textbooks that you can look at. And then it says, what are your suggestions? And there's a form for you to fill. How much will actually get done through this process? Does it seem haphazard? Is it the right way to do it?
I think something should come out of it. Let me tell you one thing. You know, when Mr. Singh asked Mr. Rajput about the low standard of NCERT books, I'll give you one very blatant example which happened in 2009. Social studies book, history book of class 9. There they had mentioned that Maulana Azad was born in UP, whereas he was born in Mecca. I mean, nothing very horrible, but then historical facts must be correct. And let me also give you an example of many Urdu textbooks a couple of years ago, which were to be published by NCERT. What they did, they talked to some professor, that professor gave the books to one of his PhD students, and these books were littered with terrible mistakes. And, many letters reached them, but nothing could be done. So NCERT must look into this facet of publishing good standardized books. And I am not looking down upon this aspect. One more thing about what Arjun was saying, that yes, you know, this is good, burden will lessen, and parents will also get some time for them. Let me tell you that if parents disassociate themselves, if the syllabus is halved, it's not a good thing. It is a good thing that parents, they help their children. So, and one fine morning, one fine evening, you come to know, yes, having the syllabus is a wonderful thing. What happened before that? It means that whatever you were doing, it was all humbug. No, please don't do that. Because parents have never complained that way. Yes, syllabus has to be that way. You have to study. You have to prove your worth. You have to show that you are the best, right? That is what Nehru did in Harrow, right?
Okay, all right. Let me also bring in my viewers on the phone line.
Can I say something?
Ashwin is on the phone line right now. I understand he's answering his 12th standard exams at this point. Kavita, I'll come to you immediately after this. Ashwin, go ahead. Do you believe that it is a good thing that the portions or the syllabus be halved so that students
have
an easier time? Ashwin.
The syllabus according to streams, you know, should be made more effective. Like, for example, we have the same mathematics portion for both commerce and science, which doesn't exactly make sense because a lot of the maths includes a lot of physics concepts, which commerce students are not going to use anywhere in their life. So reducing the syllabus is fine, but it also needs to make more sense regarding how we are going to, you know, approach our study. So I think that should be the most important change. And also, while reducing the syllabus, we should make sure that standards do not reduce of education. Because one thing where we Indians pride ourselves a lot is that we have a good high standard of education. So we also need to make sure that we don't lose out on that. So
and this is the result of 100% result studies.
Correct.
Right? No. What the child said, he understood very well.
Very well, sir. You know, Vikram Singh, I'm going to come to you with this. Is there a fear? And you, Vikram Singh said this, that we need to be number one. And it's not easy to be the most competitive or top of the charts right now at this point. So we need to be very, very clear that if we're going to make changes based on suggestions from people, as opposed to looking at it from experts, that we're not going to drop the quality in any way.
I do understand, Faye, but you must realize that Professor J.S. Rajput would remember that when he was a child, there were textbooks written by K.P. Basu and Chakravarti having 200 examples on each chapter. And today you have books that are so shoddy, as the end user himself said, that you have physics and commerce and have a mathematics that is not applicable to commerce. These are the things that require a course correction and they need to be set right so that the end user at the end of when he goes to Harvard, Stanford, Oxford or to University of Tokyo, he is not like Alice in Wonderland. He is at par with the very best in the world. Charity begins at home and magnanimity at the personal cost is one thing that I would never recommend. I would say that our children need to be the best wherever in the world.
Well, Mr. Rajput, do you want to respond to that? That the quality of our education is at question right now, not the quantity of what our students are learning.
Yes, I would like to say something.
So I want to say that
the first point I would make is the first point that I would like to make is
Mr. Rajput, yes.
Every textbook, the day it is prepared, is ready for revision. That is the basic principle of preparing a textbook. It should be ready for revision. Number two, I have not been shown any textbook and told that it is better than that of the NCERT. NCERT keeps on changing its books at regular intervals. One point was made and was very correct that NCERT should have modified its curriculum framework within 5 years. We are now using the curriculum framework of 2005 and now it is very late, already very late. It has to change. Now the point is, you cannot think only of the elite schools, only of the private schools, which prescribe much more than NCERT textbooks. In mathematics, if you go and ask the child, they will read the NCERT book plus this book plus this book plus this book. Now, there are many factors which are non-academic.
Same is the case in science textbooks also, Rajput.
The whole thing about curriculum. No, please wait. Let me finish. No,
all right, please.
You
please.
Allow me to complete my thing. Now,
let him finish.
Also is one factor. The other factor is, what about 60%, 65% of the children who are studying in the schools which do not have teachers in right proportion, who do not have qualified teachers, who do not have laboratory facilities? Yes. Now the point is, those who say that we should reduce the syllabus to 50%. The meaning of curriculum.
That is not the way. Be honest, Rajput sahab, you are such a thorough.
Sir,
scholar and intellectual,
patience,
be honest.
I will respond,
you have been
have some patience.
You have been an ex
let me finish.
CBSE in charge. Be honest.
I have been the former director.
Let me just bring in Kavita Sanghvi here. Let me bring in Kavita Sanghvi. Wanted to respond.
I have done that part, and I should be knowing
how. Yes, Kavita Sanghvi is a principal.
By the time I should have said how NCERT textbook prepared.
Yeah. So can I just give a suggestion? First of all, I fill that suggestion form, and they say that do not give anything more than 100 words. So therefore, within 100 words, I have to tell them exactly what changes I want. How much is that? As an education is also, how much can it provide? Second thing is, you know that the World Economic Forum has said that 65% of students entering primary school is going to end up in completely new jobs. So if it's completely new jobs, are your textbooks skill ready? Are your textbooks involving other jobs in it? You're in fact cutting everything down. How can you just cut everything down? You need to actually revamp and get industry connected to schools so that your students are ready for the industry in the future. So basically, you really need a real professional people coming in from every background coming in to support
Madam,
the entire curriculum. And just cutting down is not going to serve the purpose.
Reducing the syllabus to 50% is no solution
and thing
at
is when
any
I
cost.
And Kavita, I want Kavita to answer this question, please. Yes, Kavita. One second. Gentlemen, my question is to Kavita. Kavita, please respond to what Mr. Rajput said, which is that in most of the international schools, like the one that you run, you will have access to labs and computers and all of those other things. But there may be schools across the country that don't have access to that. So the syllabus actually has to keep all of these people in mind when they write it out. What is the best way to middle that ground?
Right. So the best way is to give experiential learning, which is actually hands-on learning, because hands-on learning is applicable to every curriculum. So if you look into those things, it caters to every child.
Faye.
So hands-on curriculum. Yes.
Right, Firoz, go ahead.
No, a quick remark. You see, it was said that by Mr. Rajput that what about those students who are not from elitist schools? I know most of the students are from government schools or government-aided schools. You know, the solution for that is that teachers have to be hardworking, they have to be honest to their work, and they have to be wedded to their classroom situation. And, you know, unless and until they are fair to their students, unless and until they devote time, the solution will not lie in making this, having this syllabus. So basic thing is the teachers have to be very fair and square so far as classroom studying situation is concerned.
I would like to comment on this. Let me respond to this.
I agree with that.
Mr. Rajput,
all of us must understand how the textbooks are prepared. All of us must understand how the books are prepared. Ashpal committee wrote that textbooks are normally prepared by experts without much experience of these schools. When we prepared a curriculum framework
that is very
2000,
true.
The manuscripts were, but why don't you allow me to complete my sentence? When we prepared curriculum framework 2000, we had experts, but after experts, we prepared copies. We invited 20 teachers who were teaching particular classes from all over the country. And they sat with us for 6 days. They went through every word of the manuscript and they provided wonderful inputs, which were later on, they interacted with the experts who had prepared the books. Now, that is the system we have done. Now, second point that I must make, there is an elitist group which wants to create its superiority, its advantages, its plus point. In fact, they are worried. They don't understand that the child doesn't need obsolescence to be learned. I had studied a book of 700 pages of electronics when I did my MSc. Now that 700 page electronics is now reduced about seven pages in the books. So obsolescence must be removed.
Yes, Mr. Rajput, in fact.
That is
the
unanimous.
Right. One second, gentlemen. I want to take this call. One second.
You are such a thorough scholar and intellectual.
Rajiv is on the phone line from Delhi. One second. Firozji, one second. Rajiv is on the phone line from Delhi. He's a student also, I understand. Rajiv, go ahead. We can hear you.
Yeah, good evening, everyone. First of all, I want to say that in life, quality matters over quantity. So it is also applicable to education system also. So I welcome this move. But secondly, I think it's pragmatic enough and practical enough to reduce syllabus from science and maths. Because I don't know how are you going to do that. So the only obvious subject which remains is history. So I will really like to implore and request to HRD Ministry to please eliminate and eradicate lot of nonsensical stuff which is promulgated in our history books regarding these left-wing mass murderers like Stalin and Lenin, because we don't need to learn about them. So at least our history books will become thinner.
No, hang on, Rajiv, how old are you and are you really a student? Did you lie to my team to get on the show, Rajiv?
How old political. Are you? He sounds political.
And he cut the call. That sounded political, really. And that has no room, Rajiv, whoever you are. There is no room for you and your political views in a conversation like this. This is a conversation about our children and about what's best for them. There's no room for this. Arjun Devaya, go
ahead. Ma'am, can I make a point? Yes, madam. Madam, the two youngsters, those who spoke, they really spoke their heart out. In this direction, I have one suggestion that we have been speaking about the syllabus. Syllabus or whatever they reduce, whatever quality time they are going to take out of that, it should ultimately end up in building an all-round developed child, all-round developed individual. That's number one. And second thing is, you know, the student, the child, the children are absolutely different. Each child is different. So there should be a mechanism wherein when the child comes, at the initial stage itself, I have bifurcated the children into three categories, focused, not focused, and do not want
I
to
have
focus.
A question for Arjun ji.
Rightly yes, sir ji.
No, let him finish, please.
All
let
right,
him finish,
finish
making his point.
Sir ji, no. Then, when these three categories are identified, because what happens is the classroom sessions will go on for the child in a uniform way. But there are three categories of children in the classroom. That's what I said. Focus, not focus, and do not want to focus. And rightly, as one of the panelists, one sir was mentioning, that we need to the teachers need to put their heart and soul together. They should be wedded to the classroom. Exactly there where they have to identify these children. And that communication, the parents have to be in the loop. It's a triangular thing.
Okay, so I have this question to ask at this point. Right.
No, Arjun.
I have this question to ask at this point of this entire panel. One second. Let me just refocus this conversation. Firoz. We all went to the same schools and studied perhaps the same portion. What changed in the last 15 to 20 years that parents now feel that there's too much homework, there's too much pressure on these children, that they're not getting enough time for themselves? Because I remember when I went to school, we came home, we did our homework for a couple of hours and then we ran out and played. Or you ran out and played and then did your homework for a couple
exactly.
of hours. That's just the way it went. We didn't go to tuition classes and we didn't have to spend this much.
True.
Yeah, we didn't have to. There were no tuition classes. You just did your homework. You learnt what was taught
Very
to you in
true.
School. What has changed and why are parents so worried? And why
there
is it we've reached a point where the government
then.
Itself has decided we need to relook at this. And I'm going to take this to Anubhasai. What has changed in the last 20 years, Anubhasai?
See, what I would say in last 20 years, the competition has increased. During our time, even we have studied in CBSE board schools, but during that time, the competition was not that. We used to get 70% marks was like, okay, 70% is a good mark, 70 or 80. Now the competition is 95.5, 98.8, 99.9. This is the what for children are chasing for the numbers, for getting marks. Parents are working hard for getting their child admitted in best colleges, because what colleges are now asking that your child should get 99% marks, 98% marks. That's why parents are now concerned these days. They're taking up lot of tuitions. Children are going to schools, big private schools. Parents are paying fees for 3 lakhs, 5 lakhs. But still they are sending their children to tuitions. I don't know why this change has come. What these schools are doing, I have no idea. But
can I say
right
something?
Now, the situation
Could
in
I
India is very,
her?
Very bad. Situation in India is very bad because children are chasing for marks. Parents are chasing for marks. Even schools are doing that. Because children are not getting admission in college. The cutoff level is 90%, 95%, 99%. So that should be changed.
No,
you should focus
a very
on this.
Quick.
Is that a shortage of education institutions then?
A very quick reaction, Faye, if you are.
Yes, Kavita, please. Kavita.
There is not a shortage, basically.
Kavita Sangvi. Yeah.
There is not a shortage because you actually are running after admissions. you have schools going empty, so you don't have a shortage of educational institutions actually. Basically, what happens is our parents were okay with what we were, but today's parents are having high expectations from their students, and that expectations have changed over time.
A quick reaction, Faye.
That's a change.
Yes.
May I?
Yes, Feroz, go ahead.
I heard these colleagues of mine. Basically, they said that, you know, a lot of burden, all this thing. Let me tell you one thing. All over the world where the Indian students go, they have been doing very well, whether it is in the universities or in some establishments. This is all a result of the way they have been studying very hard. Now, you asked about what is the difference between these 20 years which has occurred. Let me tell you, there was a time, rightly said by
that this is not the measure.
No, just a minute.
The measure of the quality of education.
Please let me complete.
The measure has to be very
Let me complete, please.
No, sir. According to you, Mr. Rajput, what is the measure of the quality of education?
What is the measure of the quality of education according to you, Mr. Rajput?
Very simple.
Lot of quantity but lack of quality.
In this country, only 30% children are getting education of the acceptable quality. Out of that 30%, a very small number goes outside. So that is not the measure of the overall quality of education in this country. We have to see the entire country. Those 70% who are not getting good teachers, who are not getting good schools, who don't have a lab. So you have to focus on that side also.
So
you
help in that regard, you have been a CBSE chairman.
A few thousand are in Silicon Valley. So I'm very happy. No, I'm not. I'm very much worried about the 70%.
Indulging in lip service, Rajput sir.
I must work for the 70%. That is what NCERT does.
No, no, this is not the way. See, what you are saying is right. If 70% of children who are helpless,
I have the highest regards for you.
But
it's a policy debate. Don't talk.
Gentlemen, stay on point, please.
Don't get personal. One second. Mr. Rajput. Feroz, you are both talking at the same time. Nobody can understand you. And it is.
Today, I see that the exercise books which are corrected by us. They just put a tick mark, long tick mark. There is no correction. So, you see what Arjun said. Yes, we have to be devoted to our work. That is of paramount importance. Other
all
things
right.
come
let me,
later
Let me take
on.
This question to Mr. Rajput. I don't know if Feroz can hear me. Okay, all right. Let me take this question to Mr. Rajput. Mr. Rajput, what according to you is the measure of successful education then, or the quality of education? When you were with That's the government in the HRD ministry, how did you measure success? Mr. Rajput, can you hear me? All right, I'm not sure if he can hear me, but I want to ask, there seems to be a clear, you know, difference here between Kavita Sanghvi and Anubha Sahay. Anubha said that, you know, the educational institutions are becoming more competitive. Kavita says the parents are becoming more competitive, and Kavita is a principal. So I want to go back to that. Kavita, why do you think the parents are getting more competitive right now? Why do you think that has put more pressure on the children and not the syllabus?
I guess because now that earlier you had, you were living in a joint family, there were many kids around, so you didn't have that kind of pressure, you know, that comparison. But today it's just one child, so that means my child, when he comes to the school, he should be the best at everything. So where the parents come in, they want the child to be good at every single thing. And they're not able to accept that the child is, you know, has his strengths, has his potentials, and has his weaknesses. And that is actually affected. And that is the competition is driving the parents to send the students for tuition classes. And because they are young, even KG students are going for tuition classes. And that has been growing. And at that, when it comes to 8, 9, 10, it becomes crazy. So this is exactly what we are seeing.
I just beg to differ with you. You know, you said that a lot of tuition classes for these kids. What is wrong in that? Okay, I believe that self-study is the best thing.
Right.
But what is wrong if they are getting some help? After all, they are taught.
Well,
they are
that
studying.
Depends, Mr. Feroz Bakhtemir. Do you conduct tuition classes?
Huh?
No, I, okay, all right. We have to wrap up this discussion here.
Whatever my tuitions are, I've run out of time, but I think, one second.
It's amazing that it's most difficult to get discipline on a conversation about education. All right, we've run out of time. I have to wrap up this discussion here, but in conclusion, one thing that we know for sure, and I agree with Arjun Devaya, that sports is really important, and we do hope that in this process the government finds room for sports, finds room to give marks for sports, and actually encourages more time spent outdoors for our children. The other thing we also have to look at, and we hope our government will pay attention to that as well, is space for sports, where none of our cities really have place where our children can play, and an insistence that that happens as well. But we'll keep a close eye on this, because like I told you, we have time till the 6th of April. We've put it on the bottom of our screen, and it's a website in which you can go and give suggestions to the government. We ran a poll on our Twitter handle. This is how it turned out. 75% of the people who were polled said that they do believe that the portion should be, or the syllabus should be, cut drastically to not burden children. 15% said no. Our education works, and 10% said they can't say. In the meantime, Ministry of HRD, mhrd.gov.in, suggestions. That's where you can go and give your suggestions to the government on how the syllabus needs to be modified. The HRD Ministry says it's listening and it's interested in your suggestions. Thanks for watching.